So a few days ago, Adobe released Lightroom Mobile version 9.4 for iOS and iPadOS. Now, normally I don't create videos about maintenance updates, even though I'm always a big fan of bug fixes, stability improvements, and those additional camera and lens profiles that get included. However, this update does include a new feature that I know for a fact a lot of Lightroom Mobile users have asked for over the years. It's a feature that Lightroom Desktop and Lightroom Classic users have had for as long as I can remember, and that's the ability to import individual presets and preset packs. And I consider it a big win for all Lightroom users anytime Adobe brings feature parity between its desktop and mobile apps. Now, you might be thinking that this feature isn't a big deal, but as someone who sells premium preset packs in my online store, I can confirm firsthand the number of Lightroom Mobile customers who've contacted me asking whether it's possible to import preset packs that they purchased from my store using their iPads or their iPhones. Before the update, the process to get a preset saved into Lightroom Mobile was pretty cumbersome. Now the process is as easy as ever, and I'm going to show you how it works right now. So let's dive in. All right, so here we are. This is Lightroom Mobile. I'm running it on a 12.9 inch iPad Pro M1. And obviously the first thing you're going to want to do is go into the App Store on your Apple device, search for Lightroom. You'll see in the product description there that you can now import presets, and then tap on the update button. So how do we import presets? Well, it's actually pretty straightforward. The first thing you'll need to do is get your presets locally on your iPad or your iPhone. So if we go to, for example, my store, so this is the experience. This is what it looks like if you purchase one of my preset packs. So in this case here, I'm gonna show you how to import my color grade presets. So if you make a purchase, and of course, I'll leave a link to this preset pack in the description below. But when you do make your purchase, and you log into your library, you'll see here that you can download the Matias.com color grade Adobe presets. So that's what we're going to do first. We need to get either the individual preset file or a preset pack zip file onto the iPad or iPhone. So I'm going to tap over here, and you'll see on the bottom there is this little bar that says the file name and a download link. So I'm going to tap on that, and then I'm going to tap on open in, and I'm going to tap on save to files. Now, I'm just going to save this to my iPad. So you can see on the left there, it's on my iPad. But if you use Google Drive or Dropbox, you can certainly save the zip file anywhere. But for convenience, I'm going to put it here. The other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to tap in the file name field here, and I'm going to get rid of these underscores. The reason I'm doing that is because whatever the file name is, when you import in Lightroom, which I'll show you in a second, that's going to be the group name in Lightroom. So I don't want those underscores. I just wanted to have the file name that I have set here. So with this done, I'm going to tap on save. And now that file is on my iPad. So let's go back to Lightroom over here. And the first thing I need to do is tap on the preset browser, which is this icon right there. Now you see that there are three tabs. There's yours, premium, and recommended, which is right over here. I have a whole separate video on the benefits of using recommended presets. I'll link to that at the end of this video. But one of the things I want to show you is that if you tap on premium, for example, and you tap on the ellipsis here, you'll see there are two options. There's create presets and manage presets. Same thing with recommended. If you tap here, create presets and manage presets. However, when you tap on yours, which are the presets that either you've saved or you've previously imported, if you tap on the ellipsis, you'll see there is a new option called import presets. And you guessed it, that is what we want to tap on. I'm going to tap on that right now. And you can see, there it is, the Matias.com color grade Adobe preset zip file. So I'm going to tap on this over here to import it. You'll see this dialog box come up, and you now have the Matias.com color grade Adobe presets. If I tap through here, you'll see all of the presets over here. Now, one of the best parts about importing presets using the Lightroom cloud-based ecosystem is that they sync to all the devices. So now that I've imported these presets in Lightroom on my iPad, they'll be available in Lightroom on my iPhone, on my Mac, and through a web browser using Lightroom Web, which is really awesome. Now, with this said, I have noticed so far two discrepancies, or two things at least to keep in mind when you import presets using Lightroom Mobile versus Lightroom Desktop. And I'm going to show them to you now. I'm going to show you how they differ depending on which device you import from. So here, let's go ahead. I'm going to tap on this preset here. And you can see the preset is applied. Now, two things I want you to note. First, this preset, the way it was built, supports the amount slider. So in case you don't know this or you weren't aware, Lightroom's newer presets support an amount slider. It's almost like a strength slider. And it allows you to either dial down or dial up the effect of the preset. For some reason currently, that is not supported with Lightroom Mobile. It's something I've submitted to Adobe. And so if they confirm that this is a bug, then I'm gonna create another video, an update when it's fixed. But if it's working as intended, then you should at least be aware of that. And I'm gonna show you again how it works differently with desktop. The other thing that I wanna show you is that if you tap on an ellipse here, you'll see the preset name. It adopts a specific naming convention where it's the group name, which is Matias.com color grade Adobe presets, followed by slash, and then the actual preset name. So when I created this preset pack and specifically this preset, I called it Faded Cool. But that is not visible here with mobile. It will be visible if you import with desktop. And again, I'm going to show you that in a minute. You can also see that here we do have the ability to rename. So I can go ahead here. I can rename this and just go here, get rid of that, and just call it Faded Cool. And so you have that ability. You can also, of course, export the preset or update it if you make additional changes with the editing tools. But one of the things that you can't do, unlike with desktop, is if I go here to the group names, I can't delete an entire group. Like if I swipe or tap, it just brings me into the group. I have to go ahead and delete each of the presets individually. On desktop, you have the ability to delete an entire group, which I'll show you right now. All right, so here, this is Lightroom desktop on my MacBook Pro. You can see there is the Matias.com color grade Adobe presets. And if I expand it, you can see here are all the presets, and you can see there's also that Faded Cool. Remember, we just renamed that. So not only do the presets sync, but any changes you make with file names sync as well. And again, if I click on it, you saw that amount slider appear and then disappear. That should appear. And so let me show you what the experience is like if you were to import this using the desktop. So I'm gonna go ahead. I mentioned before how on desktop, I can right click on a group and delete that entire group at once. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on delete. Those presets are gone, and they're also going to be removed from all other versions of Lightroom that I'm logged into with my Adobe ID. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna import those exact same presets by going to the ellipsis over here. I'll click on import presets, and you can see here, there is that same color grade Adobe preset file. So I'm gonna select it, click on import. And so you can see here, notice the preset names. The preset names, these are the ones that I actually applied when I created this preset pack. The other thing is if I click on a preset here, for example, Faded Warm, now you see how you have the amount slider. So you can either dial it up or dial it down, which is really important. And if I switch back to Lightroom Mobile on my iPad, you can see there is the color grades group here. And when I tap on it, I can tap on a preset. And if I tap on the thumbnail, we have that amount slider support and we have the preset names as they were prescribed when I created this pack. Now again, this isn't the biggest deal in the world. It's really awesome that we can now import presets into Lightroom Mobile. Again, I've gotten a lot of messages from people who have purchased my preset packs and they either use Lightroom Mobile primarily or exclusively. They don't even use Lightroom Desktop. So the functionality is welcome. Again, I have submitted this to Adobe because it doesn't make sense why on Lightroom Desktop, it works one way in terms of importing presets. It works the way I would expect it to, but on Lightroom Mobile, it doesn't. And if it is in fact a bug and they release a fix, I'll record another video. I'll share one, a short one, just kind of indicating that so that you'll know at least that the functionality is working as expected with the fix. With that, if you do want to check out my color grade presets, the cool thing about this preset pack is you get all of the presets built for Lightroom. And again, it syncs to all versions of Lightroom. It also works in Lightroom Classic, but there's also a LUT pack. So you can import these presets into On1 or Skyline Luminar or any app that supports LUT files. So with that, I'll leave a link again in the description below. And if you want to learn about recommended presets, I touched on it earlier, you really should know about them. Check out this video. If this video was helpful, a thumbs up is always appreciated, and be sure to click on the subscribe and bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.